What's up, beautiful people? Welcome back to my channel. On today's video, I will be sharing with you a simple banana loaf recipe. So let's jump right in. Firstly, let's work with our bananas and wet ingredients. I already have 4 small bananas in my bowl. Then I'll begin the process of mashing them. Please note, do not over mash your bananas, you guys. Just look for a consistency that's nice and gooey. My results will be a bit different because my bananas were already too ripe, so it will look a bit too soft, but don't worry about it. Next, let's add our eggs. So I am using 2 large eggs, you guys, but if you have smaller sized eggs, don't worry, you can just use 3 eggs. Okay, then I will go ahead and add my cooking oil. Proceed to add my milk, and then finally add my vanilla essence. And guys, don't worry, I will leave all the detailed measurements of all the ingredients that I used. So you want to make sure that you give this a nice stir, mix everything nicely together, and then proceed to the next step. Next, I'll be working with my dry ingredients. So I already have a cup of my all-purpose flour in my bowl. Then I'll go ahead and add my salt, my bicarbonate of soda, and lastly, my sugar. So you want to make sure that you mix these together very well, you guys. Mix them very well. And then when you are comfortable that you have mixed it very well, you want to make sure that you just create a well onto your bowl just to prepare for the process of adding your wet ingredients. But guys, don't worry too much about making your well perfect. This is just to prepare for the next step. And now we will add our wet ingredients. As you can see, you guys, they're not too thick and they're not too wet as well. The consistency is just nice and gooey. Then you will begin the process of mixing the wet and dry ingredients together. But guys, please don't be too rough when you are mixing these, because it will be very easy for you to spill some ingredients, and we don't want that. Anyway, just mix it well until it's nicely combined, and this is the consistency that you will be looking for. If you feel like it's too wet and you want to add something, don't. It's perfect. And now we will grease our pan. So I will be using my cook and bake nonstick spray, but if you don't have one, don't worry too much about it, you guys. You can use any margarine that you have on hand, and when you are done, you can go ahead and add your combined mixture. Guys, I am so sorry, I had load shedding, so I forgot to actually film a continuation when electricity came back. So you will just see me taking out the ready-made product. But guys, I did bake this for 1 hour and 15 minutes at 180 degrees. Voila, ladies and gentlemen, how gorgeous is this banana loaf? As you can see, it's nice and golden brown, literally baked to perfection. Guys, just a little note, when you are taking your banana loaf out of your pan, you want to make sure that you are very careful. Mine came out very easily, but if yours is sticky, just assist it with a knife or with any utensil that will not damage your banana loaf. It's time to, hey, cut it. As you can see, guys, I'm not struggling at all to cut it. It's actually nice and fluffy. I cannot wait to taste it, but it's absolutely gorgeous, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post a video. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Bye.